Good morning, everybody. I'm Dr. Sachin R. Gengze, Professor and Head, Department of Electronics Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Welcome to a short lecture on data and database. Learning outcome of this session include, at the end of this video, after watching this video, you will able to differentiate between data and database. As the famous investigator Sherlock Holmes has said, data, 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 I cannot make brick without clay. So it means for getting any inference out of the situation, what Sherlock Holmes requires is the data. He cannot churn out information without a data. And the very basic of his investigation is the data. This sentence is more true in today's era or today's world, because we are living in an era of data. And we can see data everywhere around us. Now, first we should understand what is a data. We know that this modern organization creates and stores vast amount of data through different storage methods. Before we understand this data, let us formally define what is a data. Now, the data can be defined as an elementary description of a thing, event, activities, and transaction that are recorded, classified, and stored. Not necessarily in an organized way. To take an example of your class data, maybe as a teacher, I'm storing the data of the class as the roll number, then the name of the student, the address of the student. So you can see that here the thing is a student, and his description, like his name, his roll number, his address, can be stored. If I'm conducting any examination, say online class test, then it can be an event or activity, and then the marks scored by the student or the attendance of the student can be the description of the activity or the event, which can I can also store. Then there can be certain transaction. For example, the student is exchanging the books in a library, so that can be a transaction, and then the data corresponding to this transaction can also be recorded. So as you can see, a data is nothing but a very basic description either of a thing or an event or any activity or the transaction. And then all this data is being recorded, classified. The classified means it is divided, and then it is stored, not necessarily in an organized way. When we talk about the word data, almost every one of us, we think that the data is only a numerical data. No. Data can be numerical data. For example, the roll number of the student can be a numerical data. His name can be an alphabet data. His address can be an alphanumerical data. So it is a combination of alphabets and the numerical. Similarly, if I'm storing the photo of a student in my data of a class data, then that data can be image also. So, right. So there can be audio, there can be video, all this description of anything or event or activity in form of numerical, alphanumerical, alphabet, images, audios, videos, everything is a data. Now, as I said, in today's world, the various organizations, they are generating huge amount of data. On the right hand side, you can see the various units that we are popularly using, like a kilo, mega, giga, tera, peta, exa, zeta, and yota. And how much data, just to give you a flavor of how much of data is being generated every day, the amount of data we produce every day is truly huge. It is estimated that there is a 2.5 quintillion, which is nothing but 2.5 exa, which is equal to 10 raised to 18 bytes of data is created every day at the current pace. And the wonder about the data, or we can say the advantage of the data or the disadvantage of the data, is that we cannot throw out yesterday's data in spite of keeping yesterday's data or 1 month before data or older data. Every day the new data is being added into the world. Now, as this data is increasing exponentially, we can say that, and again, it is estimated that 90% of the data what we see in today's world is generated over only the last 2 years. And that is what we can say, that the data is increasing every day. The organization need to protect the old data. At the same time, the new data is being added every day. What are the sources of data? Where from the data comes? The major source of the data is World Wide Web. Then the data also comes from the social media, communication, or all different type of the digital communication. Data also comes from that. Digital photos, services like the music or streaming or e-commerce. And another source of data which is now coming up is Internet of Things. So all these are the sources of data which keep on adding data every day. Now, why data is important? Why data is important? As I say, the modern organization, they create and store vast amount of data. Now, with organization having a different type of data and for technology required for storing, analyzing and reporting of data, and these technology must be powerful and fast. The powerful in the sense that these technologies or the infrastructure these organizations have to handle the data, it must be able to handle a large amount of data, and then the data must be analyzed, or if there is a query with the data, that must be served fast enough. Now the data is being processed using computer programs, and those programs we are calling as an application. Now, data can be an asset to the company, because if the company or the organization manages that data properly, and then from that data and information can be generated, and consuming this information can increase the productivity and hence the profit of the organization. And that's why the data is very important for any organization. Then we can understand what is the difference between data and database. We know, we talk about, sometimes we use these two words interchangeably. What is the data and data items? We already defined what is the data. Data is nothing but elementary description of the thing, event, activities, transaction that are recorded, classified and stored, but not necessarily in an organized manner. And this data can be numeric, alphanumeric, alphabet, images, audios, videos, right? Now, when these data items are stored in an organized way so that it can be properly retrieved, then we can call that as a database. So database is nothing but a data stored in systematic, data stored in an organized way so that either the data items can be retrieved easily or the data items can be converted into information and can be retrieved easily. Now we can say that instead of storing the data of a class just in any way, if we store the data like rows and column, where the rows represent the row represent entry of a particular student, and the column represent the various attributes like a roll number, name, address and gender. Now this is a systematic way of storing a data, and we can say that it's a basic table in a database. Because suppose I want an information, what is an address of the roll number 5, I can go to this table and can find out roll number 5 is address F5 Narmada apartment. Or I can, if I want an information like how many boys and how many girls are there in a class, I can scan the gender column and then I can find out how many boys and how many girls are there. So data, when stored in an appropriate way, it's called as the database. Now here is the first question for today's lecture. So what is the difference between data and database? So you can pause the video for a while and then differentiate between what is a data and database with an example. So I think that you have now it is very clear to you what is the difference between data and a database. We can go further, and we have understood the first two things, what is a data and a database. Now this can be extended further to have some more terms like information, knowledge and wisdom. What is the information? Information is nothing but data atoms that has been organized so that it has a particular value or meaning to the recipient. If we can extract some meaning or value out of the data atoms, then it becomes an information. Knowledge is gained when the information is consumed and used for the decision making. So whatever the information we are taking out of the database, if we can use it for particular decision making or particular application, then it is called as the knowledge. And wisdom is an integrated knowledge information made super useful. Wisdom is also defined as knowing the right thing to do. Now let us take an example of this data, information, knowledge and wisdom. So as you can see, this is an example of an autonomous car. Suppose the sensor system or the image system of the car reads certain coordinate. Okay, so that is a raw data. Now assigning a meaning to that is a particular south facing traffic light on the corner of a particular square becomes red. That is the meaning. Now the context is that the particular car is driving toward the same square, and then it means that the signal which is meant for us is now, it has now become red. So that is a knowledge. And then the wisdom is that whenever I have a red signal in front of me, then I should stop the car. So that is called as the wisdom. So you can see that from a raw data which represents certain image coordinate and certain data or data picked up by the sensor, that raw data can be converted into information. Information can be converted into knowledge, and knowledge can be converted into wisdom. So this we have seen. And with that, we come to the end of this lecture. The references I have used for this lecture include Information Technology for Management by Turban, Volvino and Renner Potter. And the second book is Information System by Ralph Steer and Reynolds. Thank you very much for listening and attending this lecture. Thank you.